There are three main jumping events: the long jump, triple jump, also known as the hop, step and jump, and the high jump. As well as being individual events, the jumps are also part of the heptathlon and decathlon. The aim in jumping is to cover the greatest distance, either horizontally or vertically. For each type of jump, there are different physical needs and suitable body types.
Long jumpers and triple jumpers, we like to have a bit of natural speed because it's important there's speed on the runway, and are pretty strong as well. Not like beefy thrower strong, but power strong. They don't necessarily have to be very tall, but they don't want to be carrying any excess weight or anything like that. For high jumpers, we're looking for the classic long, skinny Tim Forsyth type shape who have got a good takeoff.
Kirsteen Farrance is a former heptathlete, now a level 2 jumps coach, working with young athletes to develop their potential. Although the physical requirements of the jumps may vary, they all have the same basic structure.
There's a number of common phases to all the jumps. There's firstly your run-up, which has to be very accurate. In all the jumps, it has to be very accurate and very consistent, because if you do something wrong in the run-up, then you've stuffed up your jump. And then there's the take-off, and in all the jumps, it's the same. It's keeping a long, thin shape, driving with the knee, and being active at takeoff and going up in the air and using your free knee to drive. Third phase is the flight phase, which obviously in high jump is to clear a bar, and that's the main aim of it. And in long jump and triple jump, of course, is to cover horizontal distance. So flight in high jump is vertical, and the flight phase in long and triple is the horizontal distance you're trying to cover. And the final phase is the landing. Okay, very important in long and triple, because if you don't get your bottom past your feet or you mess it up somehow, then you're going to have your jump either no jumped or it's going to be shorter than you really wanted it to be. The landing in high jump, obviously there's a safe way to land, and it's important what you land on is safe in terms of the bags.
Long jump pits should be cleaned and then dug over to loosen the sand for soft landings. The track should be cleared of sand and the takeoff board swept clean. Just as important as preparing the venue, the athlete should also prepare for any training sessions or competitions.
Prior to actually jumping, you want them to be warming up correctly and warming up especially the lower back for high jump and major muscle groups for the other jumps as well.
Warming up starts with stretching exercises. The athlete should gently stretch the long leg muscles. The trick is to move slowly into the stretching position and gradually apply pressure. When the muscle is at full stretch and just starting to become uncomfortable, ease off the pressure a little and hold that position for between 5 and 10 seconds. Ease out of that position and reverse it to stretch the corresponding muscles. In warming up and stretching, always remember to move slowly from one exercise to the next. The stretching exercises are a vital part of any training session, and adequate time should always be allocated before starting any drills. Once the athletes have loosened up, they move on to a series of run-throughs, building up their speed. This completes the warm-up, although athletes should always try to stay loose and warm throughout the training session. In the long jump, contestants sprint along a runway and spring into the air from the takeoff board, with the aim of covering the greatest possible horizontal distance. While still in the air, the jumper throws both feet far forward of the body to increase the distance and prepares to land.
Cameron, off you go.
In this training session, Kirsteen is taking a group of athletes through the long jump.
Okay, that was your left foot, Jacob.
The first step is to find out which is the athlete's natural takeoff foot.
Okay, that was your right foot. You don't have to take
this
off
leg
the board.
Gives the initial power thrust into the air, with forward drive or momentum provided by the other leg and its opposite arm as they swing through.
First thing we're going to do is just concentrate on the takeoff. Now, we're not going to be working off the board, we're going to be working on the bit of track between the board and the pit. And all I want you to do to concentrate on is keeping up nice and tall and driving with the bent leg. Okay, so in your case, you're a left foot takeoff, you'll be driving with your bent right leg. You to a right foot takeoff, you'll be driving with a bent left leg.
In the next drill, the athletes are learning to stretch out with their takeoff leg, while keeping the long, thin shape that will give maximum distance.
Okay, good. Don't sort of tuck your legs up under you, keep up nice and tall.
The priority in this drill is to get the body into the right takeoff position.
The idea is you take off, you come in to take off, you hold your takeoff position, but part of the drill is to land in the sand. You'll hit the sand with your takeoff foot first, all right, and then you land on that knee or on your takeoff leg knee with your free knee up in front of you. Got it. Okay, now see where you landed? Your foot and your knee was really close together. All right, I want a big split. Big split between there and there. Good boy, well done. So far we've done the first bit of the drill, which is the takeoff, if you like, and concentrating on keeping up nice and tall and driving that free knee or free thigh up to horizontal. Okay. The second part of the drill we did was the takeoff, holding that position and then landing in a wide split in the sand. Now the reason for the wide split is that now we're going to go on to the third bit, which is actually bringing that takeoff leg around to join your other foot for landing. So the reason for the big split is we want your feet out as far as possible to cover as much sand. So when you bring your takeoff leg through, it's out there. So the next part of the drill is what we've been doing, running down, taking off, big split in the air, but I want you to bring the other leg together so you land 2 feet together. Try when you take off, opposite arm, opposite leg, hold it up there. Keep your upper body up, okay, and then join the two legs together. All right, remember, you hold your takeoff position first, then you extend. Good try. Good. Okay, let me see your arms up there at takeoff. Let's run over it again. We've done takeoff. So we've got to hold the takeoff position like in any jump. We've got to hold the takeoff position. Okay, so the takeoff position is a long, thin shape at takeoff. Free thigh up, opposite arm, opposite leg. Okay, and then we've gone into that big split position. Okay, and now we've gone to bringing the other foot with it. Now, what do we do with the arms? All right, it's be interesting. Okay, because sort of some of you are just sort of holding them back here. All right, we've taken off, we've split. Now, as this leg comes up, that arm comes over to reach for you both of your feet. It's a bit hard doing it standing up, isn't it? On one leg, so I've taken off, I've driven, I'm splitting, stretching over the sand for that distance, and the opposite arm comes over as this leg comes up. That position is what we call the jackknife position for landing. Okay, try it again. So you're in takeoff. Remember, you get that opposite arm, opposite leg at takeoff, and that's got to be emphasised. Stretch it out. Bring the other arm over. And at the same time, that leg will come up to meet the other one. Good try. Okay, don't drop your head down. The minute you stick your head down, what happens is what we call forward rotation. The minute your upper body starts rotating forward, your legs will go down. So the idea is to keep your upper body up and sort of jackknife, lie across your legs if you like. It's very hard because you've got to be pretty strong in here.
Long jumping requires strong leg and abdominal muscles, running speed and leg spring.
Remember to get, now you're a right leg takeoff, you're there, so keep that arm there, don't let it waver behind you. So that's there and you bring the other one to meet it. Where your feet land in the sand is where your jump's going to be marked from, alright? So you don't want to have your bottom landing behind your feet, you want it landing past your feet. All right, so there's two possible styles of jumping, landing, sorry. Claire, can I just have you sitting in the sand? Feet about there, or heels. All right, down you go. All right, now, I'm just going to put my feet on your toes. I promise I won't squash them. All right, just imagine if Claire's just off your feet, coming through. It's what we call the scoop through, so she comes through over her feet. Okay. So she wouldn't have sat in the sand beforehand. She would have landed on her heels and then scooped through. So the idea is that she's come past her footmarks and just come straight over the top. There is a danger, of course, of possibly scraping the sand behind your footmarks. Now, another possible landing technique is one called the swing away. All right, so if you're jumping, the jumper's feet hit the sand and you can swing your bottom to either the left or the right. First thing, she lands and her heels hit the sand first and swings to the left. Okay, so you can see that her heels are back here, her bottom's up here, All right, and it's not going to interfere with the marks for a jump. Now that is a hard technique to learn. A lot of the jumpers you'll see at the moment will land basically side on, fall into the sand side on. The trick is to let your heels hit the sand first, then you swing your bottom away. Just have a try, standing long. Okay, so now see how you were like that? Upper body up when you jump. Try and get your legs out in front of you. Okay, you sort of do a scoop over, a very dainty scoop over. Now, before we can even take off in the air, the run up. All right, how do we work out a run up in long jump? What I'm going to do each of you to do in turn is with your takeoff foot on the takeoff board. Okay, so you'll be placing your takeoff foot, if we imagine that's the front of the board, closest to the pit, about there. Starting with about there. All right, and then I'm going to ask you to run past me, all right, at the speed you would run in for high jump or long jump or whatever it might be. In other words, not flat out, all right, because if you sprint in flat out in a long jump, you can't take off on the other end. So I want you to run at a speed that you think you can jump at. And I'm going to count your strides, and we're going to work out a 15 or 16 stride run up. 12, 14, 16. Don't slow down as you come to me, just keep normal running form as you go. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. What we're going to do now is do it the proper way. Just do exactly the same thing. You're going to put your takeoff foot at your marker and run towards the board. Don't stop at the board, don't look down at the board. Just look up and run through the pit. It's my job to see where your foot lands. Right, that's where your foot was. What did it feel like when you got to the board? As though you could jump? Comfortable? Cool, that's good. Okay. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. What did that feel like? Not too bad. That's where your foot was. Take off. Okay, so we're a bit behind the board. We'll do it one more time, and if you're still in the same spot, we'll bring it forward. Okay. Move it forward 3 of your foot lengths. Good. Okay, good try. Good try. You're slowing down a bit towards the end of the run up, and your head went down towards the end, but at least you tried to hold that takeoff position. That was good. You've got to concentrate on driving the knee off the board. It's the same for every jump, is that bent knee drive.
The aim in the triple jump is to cover the greatest horizontal distance in a series of 3 quick leaps. In the first phase of the sequence, the jumper sprints along the run-up, hops into the air from his preferred takeoff foot, and comes down on the same foot. The jumper then springs or steps forward onto the other foot and then drives forward once more to land in the pit with both feet together.
A lot of the elements of triple jump are the same as long jump. So in terms of working out your run up, take off, etc., and landing is very similar to long jump. Okay, but what I'm going to concentrate on here is the 3 phases in between your take off and your landing, namely your hop, your step and your jump. Okay. Secret of triple jump is to keep the 3 phases even. Okay, so we don't want a really high hop and a little step and a big jump. They've all got to be even. Now, one of the ways of teaching this is using the lines of the track to teach you how to get the rhythm of the 3 phases going, so that you listen to when your feet are landing to 3 even sounds. Okay, so just one of you in that gap and one of you in that gap. Okay, and what I want you to do is stand on your takeoff leg, on your preferred takeoff leg. All right, you're going to hop to the next line and hold it. Have a go. And hold. Step to the next line and hold. Okay, and jump to the next line and hold. Okay, now sometimes we have to get down to the talking sequence where it's same, other, together. All right, so you hop from the same foot onto the same foot, from one foot onto the same foot, you step onto the other foot, and you jump with your 2 feet together. All right, hop, step, jump. Okay, now just a thing with the step, it's actually what I call a bounding step. So you've hopped to there, I want you to bound step. All right, so I don't want just to see step, all right, I want to see a bound step. Okay, hop, bound step, good, jump. Okay, now I want you to try it without stopping in between, so run the three together. Start on the line. When you're ready. Good, okay. All right, let's change the spacings a bit. Okay, all right. Try not to let your upper body rock forward. It's got to be kept up all the time. All right, one way to keep your chest up is to stick your knee up there. Sort of, we're getting there. All right, now you should have heard, at least I heard it, I don't know if you heard it, but the sounds of you landing were very even. Now, what I want you to do this time is you flow your hop and your step on with your jump, but landing your jump in the pit this time. Okay, so it's important to land where the cones are. Go. Okay, Cameron, keep upright, you're that way. All right. Claire, try, or both of you, try and drive, rather than that way, drive out across the track. All right, the idea with the three phases is to cover as much track as you can. All right, remember, 2/3 of the jump is before you get near the pit. Good try, much better. Did it feel better? Yeah, good. All right, one concept I haven't talked about, but it's relevant to all the jumps, it's called active landing. Because not only is it a landing, you've got to take off again. All right, so you don't want to be sort of thumping into the ground and losing all your momentum into the ground. Okay, so you want this, what we call an active landing, which is like trying to claw the track back. All right, so you're there and you can come off it again. All right, and it's much more forgiving on your legs as well. Okay, have a try. Getting there. It's something that everyone uses. It's used in all the jumps, it's used in hurdles, so it's important. Okay, Cameron, I want you to try it with a bit of a run up. Remember getting the three phases even. Okay, jump into the pit. Okay, give yourself a bit more space at the back to run in a bit more, okay, because you need a bit of speed to do it as well. Good. With the hop phase especially, you've got to keep it flat. All right, so you've got to go across the ground. Not up. All right, your upper body's up, all right, but I don't want you to jump up, I want you to jump out. All right, so you're hopping out and you're stepping out. Good. Can you hear your landing? It's very even and that's good. All right, so now what you need to concentrate on, or we need to do with you, is just keep putting the cones further and further apart so that you're stretching all the time. Good. Sounding really nice and even. That's good. That's excellent.
The aim in high jumping is to clear a crossbar resting at progressively greater heights between two upright standards, about 4 metres apart. Most jumpers today employ the style known as the Fosbury flop to clear the bar. To execute the flop, jumpers approach the crossbar with a run-up shaped like an open J. They leap and rotate on takeoff, rise above the bar head first, clear the bar with their backs toward the landing bags, and land on the bags with their shoulders.
The first thing we're going to do, just to get you familiar with landing on your back, is what we call backovers, onto the bag, over the bar. Now we're using what's called a flexi bar, okay? As the name suggests, it's not hard, so it doesn't matter if you land on it. What I want you to do is standing with your back to the bar, foot or so out, jumping up and landing on the bags. Clear, you can never go first. Okay, good. Cameron. Okay, just wait till clear's off. Okay, go. Good. Okay. Just wait, Jacob. Good. All right, variation to this one. Now, Claire, you're a right foot takeoff, so you'll be coming from this side. What I want you to do is just tilt that way and look down the bar that way. Okay? Okay, good. Now, Cameron, as you're a left foot takeoff, you're going to be coming from this side. So add a bit. Right, tilt your shoulders that way and look down the bar that way. Good. Now, Jacob, you're the same side as Claire. So just a little bit that way. That's right, and looking down the bar that way. Good. Okay.
As with all jumps, the run-up is crucial.
Okay, what we're going to do is measure the run-up. We measure the run-up from your respective uprights. Okay, we don't measure the run-up from the centre of the bar, we measure it from the upright so that you actually clear the bar in the centre. Two good reasons why we clear the bar in the centre. The bars sag, so the lowest point is in the centre, and if you jump at the centre of the bar, the bags are nice and safe. Okay, if you're jumping to either end, you can miss bags. So, just to take you through it, we're going to measure up a 5-stride run-up. We start with our back to the upright. Now, I'm a left foot takeoff, so I'm on this side. I walk out 3 ordinary walking steps, then I'm going to turn out at right angles. Okay, so I turn out and I walk 2 steps and I put a marker. Okay, so I've gone 3, 2. Now I stand looking directly out and I just shuffle a few degrees around. Okay, and I walk 4 and I'll put a mark down. Okay, and that should be my 5-stride run-up with my first step with my takeoff foot. Have a go. Set up your own.
These young athletes are training with a 5-stride run-up. In competition, the most common run-up is 9 strides. To measure the extra distance, simply add 8 walking steps to the final stage of the set-out.
Right, the first thing we're going to do is drills. Okay, it's what we call high knee drills and high knees with takeoff. Okay, so you're going to do it off your run-ups. Right, and you're going to keep up nice and tall and keep your head up by looking at the bar. Okay, off you go. First step is with your takeoff foot. Okay, go. Good try, good. Good, good, good. Okay, keep your eyes on the bar all the time. Right, the next drill I want to do is the one with takeoff. So it's exactly the same, but when you get to your closest upright, you're going to drive up with the appropriate knee and hold it. That's better. Okay, all right. Okay, but you lost your high knees. The idea is to keep your high knees going, keep it nice and rapid, but that was all right, that was good. Take off. Good, okay. Don't look down at the last minute. Keep your head up as you take up, take off. What we're going to try now is just see the marks we've put down, see how well it fits our 5-stride, all right? So I'm going to take the bar down. What I want you to do is run normally, all right? 5 strides onto the bag. 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. A bit quicker. steps at the beginning, all right? Don't take a little first step, take a bigger first step. Okay. All right, but when you step up onto the bags, you sort of crunched over. With all the jumps, as I've been saying all day, get up tall, okay? All right.
Once the run-up has been adjusted for the optimum takeoff, the athletes can put the jump together in its full sequence of run-up, take-off, drive, flight and landing.
That's all right, it's pretty light for you. Good, that was much better. Okay, I'm going to get you to do a jog-in. You can't propel yourself quick enough. Jog-in is what I mean, jog-in. Okay, now you've got to make sure that the right foot hits that mark. One, two, three, four, five. That looked more comfortable. Too close or more cut? Was it all right? All right, I'll put the bar back up and you can try it with a scissor. You sort of hurdled it. It's a bent knee. You don't get any drive with a straight leg. All right, it's got to be bent. So you punch it up bent. Still sort of lying over a bit early. If we can get this shoulder up and round, it'll keep you from diving over it too early. But that was better. All right, now, the thing is at takeoff, we've got to keep up nice and tall. Just like in the long jump when I said you've got to keep up tall at takeoff, exactly the same thing here. See how the same things keep coming up all the time for the jumps? Amazing, isn't it? That was better. That was better. It's getting there very slowly. You're still leaning into it too early, but it's getting there. Right, the run-up was better. You're tending to dive over a bit, but we can work on that.
As the technique becomes second nature to the athletes, regular practice and increasing the bar height will improve their style and performance.